Hey there, lads and lasses. This here is Thunderhand 64 coming at you live from the west coast of the United States here on a Friday morning. And let me drop the background music a little bit more into the background. There we go, just like that. Okay, so as you may recall, yeah, we're going from 11 to 1 for Buffooncraft on Friday, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. Pacific Standard Time on Buffooncraft. On Fridays, we really need to pick up Kachi earlier in the afternoon. Excuse me. And so, you know, I have a choice either to stream, you know, earlier in the day, towards the morning, into the afternoon, or much, much later in the evening, you know. And so I think to accommodate our friends across the Atlantic there and friends east of us, and that's the majority of you. I think earlier is better. So we're going to try 11 to 1 for a little while, and we're going to see how that goes. I apologize for the long stream intro. I had a couple of last-minute things to do here. I've got a lot of things going on at the Thunderhand household. But anyways, okay, here we are. Ready to stream something for Buffooncraft. All right, so let's at least let's recap. Yeah, that's actually more like it. Recap. I had my sights set on designing a raid farm. I thought that would be a really useful farm for us in our Buffooncraft map at this stage of the game. And so in order to, you may be familiar how raid farms work. You need some source of pillagers, usually a pillager outpost. You travel to the outpost, you then get the a bad omen, right? You kill a raid captain, you get the bad omen, and then you go back over to the farm with the bad omen and you trigger a raid, right? So we needed an outpost, and preferably we needed an outpost that was near the shoreline, because the farm really needs to be built out over the water to function properly. But as it turns out, this particular mod that we're using is a fantastic mod, and I do love it. But it has modified the pillager outposts in such a way that they do not spawn pillagers. Now we do have these mod generated ships out on the water with spawners built inside them that spawn pillagers, but we don't like to use non-vanilla spawners for farms, so that leaves us without any capacity to get bad omen really on demand to run the raid farm. So one of the thoughts I had, so there's two thoughts going forward on that. One, wait until the borders expand and hopefully we can find an NPC, a vanilla outpost. I'm tending to think that the mod has probably replaced those outposts with the ships, with the spawners, because I can't really see having both. I haven't confirmed it 100%, but I do suspect that. Or I can appeal to Nova and just ask him, look, can I use the spawners on the ships? Because we're not using that to make the farm itself. We're just traveling there to get the bad omen, right, from killing one of the captains. So we're not really using the mod-generated spawner for the farm itself. We're just traveling there to get the bad omen. So I think that should be reasonable. I think that's kind of vanilla gameplay, as you know, because, again, you know, we're not using the ship and the spawner for the farm itself. You know, the farm itself actually has to be constructed away from the source of the bad omen. So I don't know. He's pretty reasonable, so I think I might be able to appeal to him. But neither, regardless, Raid Farm is on hold now, and that kind of leaves me in a limbo as to what to do for the stream, because I wasn't prepared for that. So what to do now? What to do now? Again, you know, I don't really have an idea for a base for this season yet. That hasn't manifested itself in my little brain. And so, you know, I don't really have anything ready for that either. One of the things I was considering was to ask Shut Mountain if I could upgrade the iron farm. Again, you know, Shut Mountain jumps right into the map and builds several farms right away to get us up and running. But I think the output of the iron farm really needs to be enhanced. The output of the pumpkin farm for the trading hall has been enhanced by Shelbs, and she did a knock-up job on that. But I think we really also need to upgrade the iron farm for that. One of the things we could do is to go into the creative test world. There's Greener. Do the Spartans generate banner pillagers? You know, Greener, I think we could go try that out. I think we can. And why isn't the auto shout out working for you? Did you change your Twitch name? Because you definitely should get an auto shout out for that. But let's, in the meantime, let's do the manual shout out. I did. Okay, that's why. So I have to edit my bot and update it. And I will do that. But let's do a manual shout out. The mighty, the one and only, the Greener Canuck, our fellow buffoon and charity streamer and alchemist on the server. I am Canuckless. Yes, I noticed that. Okay. Because now in Discord, even though you have your set username, you can kind of like temporarily change the way your name looks, and it doesn't affect that like a new account. But I see. All right, so. And there we go. Okay, that's great. So, Greener, welcome in. How are you doing today? My other mathy buffoon. The original mathy buffoon. Yay! Thank you. You are most welcome, sir. I guess one of the first things we can do is let's travel to one of those ships and see if it generates a raid captain, right? Because if it's just just the standard pillager, then that's not going to work, right? So let's go do that. Let's go confirm that. And like I said, you know, if that doesn't pan out, maybe we can go into the test world and design an iron farm. One of the things I've been wanting to do with that is to establish in my test world some of the parameters of the iron farm that I worked out. Oh yeah, you're in the server. Excellent. It's been a while since I've seen you there, sir. That's gonna be cool. As I was saying, last season in season 4, you know, I learned quite a bit about iron farms, but you know, I like to take the things that I learn in Minecraft like that, and I like to set them up in my test world, because getting on in my years, short-term memory isn't there, you know, and so I like to, you know, build those in the test world, and that way I can just refer back to them whenever I need to. Okay, well, we're in the server, in our room above the pub. Yes, we live in the pub. Hey there, alchemist. So let's head downstairs. Let's go over to the garden area. And let's go click the button and let our friends know. That we are streaming, just in case anybody else other Okay, you see my name in the tab list has gone purple. That lets everybody know in the server that, you know, we are streaming. So we do that. Okay, you know, one thing I want to get into the habit of checking the mailbox each time. Okay, we have no mail. Good. Okay. Checking the mailbox each day. We're good there. Okay, we can travel over to the nearest ship, and I think the ships are out by Nebs and Shut Mountain. So, that being considered, let us travel out there. And Roof of the Nether really is the way to go. So, Greener, on what are you working today? Are you out at your base, or? Also, we have limited amount of Bad Omen 5 potions. Not sustainable, but hey, oh. Bad Omen 5 potion. There you go. That might just solve the entire problem, right? A limited amount. I'm on the roof of the Nether looking at the new stuff. Okay, I'm on my way there now, as a matter of fact. Now, is the Bad Omen 5 potion, is that exclusive to this mod? Because I don't remember that being in vanilla. But, you know, Mr. Alchemist, sir, if you wouldn't mind collaborating on that. But you said we have a limited amount. Does that mean that we can brew only so much of that? Yeah, mod. We can't make them. Ock. Ock. If I know you, you're probably up at the gold farm, right? Because you said you're on the roof of the Nether. So, viewers, you may have noticed that the gold farm has been changed significantly. There are certain things in the mod, like we have water protection and certain potions like that, too, that are mod-specific. But, yeah, we can't brew things like that. I'm taking it all in the scene. Yeah, okay, cool. And Shelbs is raiding with a party of three. Why, hello there, Shelbs. Another one of our illustrious buffoons. So you can see Nova did quite a bit on the item sorter and collector for the piglin trading, which is incredible, by the way. Plus, something I wanted to study when I get a little bit of time. Where is that? That's up here. I think it can be seen from this angle. It might be occluded by the blocks. He might have covered it up. But there's a dispenser kind of item transportation system that transports items instantly. I mean, from I forget what the length limit is, but from in one tick, from here to here. And that is a really, really handy, and it's pure vanilla mechanics. I think I saw Tango Tech use that one time in the decked out too. And the mighty Shut Mountain. And we finally found out who kidnapped the alchemist. I still don't know, but I know the alchemist is present. I mean, see, we can't see gameplay. Yes. Shelbs, how's it going? Shelbs, it is going awesome, and all the better for having you drop by. Thank you so much for the raid. Shelbs, what were you streaming? Because I didn't see you. I haven't even... I just flipped on Twitch now, and so I just missed your stream. Scene change, yes. That's what Greener's talking about. Yeah, like I said, I am struggling today. There we go. Okay. So, yeah, the gold farm has been updated quite a bit here, and we have the instant transportation system. That I want to take a look at because I have quite a few redstone mechanics things for Buffooncraft, Generations, and otherwise that I could definitely use that for. Oh, some Vault Hunters. Yeah, you've been playing quite a bit of that, right? Joined a new server to play Sky Vaults. Okay, yep. Yeah, guessed. There we go. So getting all set up again. Oh, cool. Very, very cool. Well, again, thank you so much for the raid. Right, so the gold farm, which is the main feature of our builds on the nether, on the roof of the nether right now, has been greatly upgraded. And that's super cool. That's been required for quite some time. Although we have been getting by with it just fine for early game. But the other main feature is the guardian farm, which we showed off last time, of which I've upgraded the storage for. And we do have the Ghast farm. It's a prototype. It does need to be modified and enhanced. But, you know, I don't really feel like doing that now. I did have my heart set on the raid farm for right now, and I'm not really ready to get back on that. And, of course, the one and only Angel Bayou. Good morning / afternoon. Welcome in, Angel. Angela, are you still traveling or are you home yet? And I apologize for, you know, not knowing. I haven't been able to stop by the Discord lately. How are you? This is Fine Friday. Yes, indeed it is. Oh, hey, Shut Mountain, since I have you on here, would you mind terribly if I did some upgrades to the iron farm and increased its output? Since you are not only the creator of the iron farm, but also the current king. I'm home and packing up for camping trip. Oh, okay, cool. You know, since I moved away from New Hampshire and I'm out here in California, camping is one thing that I've sorely missed. For some reason, I was having trouble recognizing Shut's base, and I've been out here so many times. Yeah, so I don't know if you've noticed, but I'm very tired and struggling very much with the stream right now. So, Shut, do whatever you need to do, my dude. Okay, all right, that's something we can consider too. Okay, there we go. Let's do as Greener had suggested, though, and let's travel out to a ship and let's confirm whether or not those spawners inside the ships will spawn raid captains. We know they spawn villagers, I mean pillagers, but the raid captain itself, it doesn't. So we were thinking potions, but we have a limited amount of those and we can't brew those. And then we have the option of asking Nova if I can use the ships, if anything, just to get the bad omen. But before we even bother asking that, making that request, we should confirm whether or not they produce the captains, the raid captains. So let's just get over to the nearest ship here. And let's let's climb on up and let's have ourselves a butcher. Have ourselves a look. I should pick up my bass right now. I'll spare you all that, though, for the moment. Have the spawners been broken on this one? Maybe. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, they have. All right, we'll go to another one. We have plenty of ships around that are still active, so we can go do that. Oh, we have a lot just in this area, too, so. I think they're more out this way, though. But thank you so much, Buffoons, for dropping on in and stuff. It's really cool to see you guys. Okay, yeah, there's the next nearest ship right over here. I think Greener's working on his base, hence the sneak achievement, advancement. He's probably working up there in the heights. All right, maybe this one is still active. We can go check this out. Nope, at the gas farm. Oh, okay, cool. Yeah, the gas farm we discussed on the last stream. I think it was the last stream. And I was thinking maybe just set up an etho hopper clock underneath and do away with the skulk sensors. Although that was a very fun idea. And just run them on a clock. And that's probably what I'm going to do. This one's also been neutralized. All right, one of these hasn't, though, and it's nearby. I just have to remember which one of these ships it is. Where's me boot? Me boat. But there's lots of these ships around. I think there's another one over this way. Yeah, there's one here. Still walking on top of the nether, yeah. Yeah, the gas farm is a lot of fun. I really like doing that, and I like the collaboration on it. I thought that was a lot of fun. This one has scaffolding. This one might have been neutralized as well. I know there's at least one of these ships around here. Oh, that's the original one with the black sails. That's why. Yeah, I'm going back in the other direction. Yeah, you can. Yeah, see, this stream is a struggle, everybody. Just be patient. Be patient. The brain will kick in, hopefully. Let me see. This is over by Neb's place. Let's stay clear of the Guardian Farm, shall we? The other ship might be beyond that one, actually. I know there's another one quite a ways back in the other direction beyond the black sails ship. Yeah, we can go around past this one. Turbo's base is over there. Nebs's base is behind me, and you've seen Shut's base over there with the Guardian Farm. So I spent quite a bit of time the last few days of this week out here. You can see that pillager tower. Those towers are merely decorative, and they do not produce pillagers. And I did a lot of work on that tower trying to prep it to test whether or not it would spawn pillagers, and it does not. Yeah, as Nova says, those are a one and done. They spawn initially, and they may... spawn an initial group of pillagers, but then they're neutralized after that. They go inactive after that, and they're merely decorative. So I was over here and I set up my usual setup to optimize one of these towers. You get the 72 by 72 by 54 cube all cleared out with the grass blocks or sand blocks. I could have left the sand if I wanted to. I use grass because it differentiates from the landscape, you know, and centered on the tower top level up there. But as you can see, this will not spawn any pillagers. So I did quite a bit of work on this. I chose this one because this was the closest one, I believe, to the... yeah, it wasn't as far out, so that would have been a much quicker trip. So then I did a test on one of the submerged pillager towers over here. I set up a platform of grass blocks within its spawn cube here just to see if it would spawn any pillagers, and it did not. So these are also decorative. Right now, I understand that these are dirt blocks, but I set up some grass in order for this to spread. And, you know, this does not spawn pillagers. So those two tests pretty much confirmed what we had suspected all along. Now, there's another ship out here. I think this one spawns. This one hasn't been neutralized yet. So, hey, to inform you that these ships will not spawn, dude, with banners that I have seen. I've seen a couple, though, but the ships themselves may also be a one and done. One of the ships I went on was just loaded with pillagers, and they had spawners underneath, and the spawners were very, very, very much active. But these here, I can hear, usually I can hear the pillagers inside them, and this one I don't hear anything. Yeah, see, this one's been cleared out. I did have a ship, though. I did come across a ship that was just that the spawners in which the spawners were still active, and they were just cranking out the pillagers. In fact, that might have actually even been on last stream. I just forget where said ship was. But it makes sense that all of these ships that are nearby land... have all been raided. So, Loon and I went out and raided a bunch of the smaller ships. Okay. Was that since last Friday? It seems like the more and more ways I think to get around this raid farm thing, the more and more I'm just being shut down at every conceivable counter idea I come up with or solution. Yes, uh-oh. Yeah, that does not bode well for us. Okay, there's two more ships there, but you guys may have wiped these ones out. Shelb's raid indeed. Woo! Welcome in, IT guy. How was your Friday? Let's do a little bit of sleeping over here. So I think we're gonna wind up in the test world today. Doing raid farms. Iron farms, I mean. Iron farms. That's probably what's going to happen. Yeah, let's go with... Okay. All right. All right. Yeah, we've got a number of ships right here. Maybe there might be one that Shot and Lone have overlooked. Ah, I hear pillagers inside. Oh, yeah. Okay. Shield's up, Scotty. Ooh, this shield is really close to... Now, if I'm not mistaken, the spawners are below. Oh, hey, I was looking for one of these for the pub. Okay, let's see if we can see any of these dudes with the banners. I don't think so. Greener, you know, I think you might have a point there. I think these might spawn only the regular pillagers and not the captains. Because I don't see any of the raid captains down there. Fuck! No raid farm! Yeah, I'm just looking at these guys, and I'm not seeing any banners. I know I'm taking a lot of arrows right now, but I've got some major heavy-duty armor. I see a crossbow floating there, but I'm not seeing any of the... I'm not seeing any of the banners, the raid captains. I can hear a zombie knocking down a door somewhere. let me see. That's too bad. Yeah, that would have been a fine solution, Greener. And you know what? I think if I asked Nova, you know, if I could just use the ships just to board them, get the bad omen, and then leave, I think he would have been fine with that. Because, like I said, you know, we're only getting the... We're only using it to get the bad omen. We're not, Oh, hello, fellas. See, sometimes if you line these guys up just right, you can get them to shoot each other. And, that makes things work out all for the better. But I don't see any captains. Yeah. Fuck. Ooh, I see a skelly down there. Yeah. All right, well, there's no point hanging out down here any longer. Where's me bullet? And let's see what we got going here. At least you are going to find some decent loot. Just make sure you dig out the wheat and find the hidden barrel. Choo-choo man! Hi, I recently watched Chris's stream. So if it's so it's cool seeing other people's stuff. I really like salmon. Welcome in, Choo Choo. And hey, thank you so much for that follow. Really appreciate it. Welcome on in. Yeah, there it is. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Welcome, welcome, welcome to Fulcheroo. Alrighty, so I guess our raid farm plans have been totally neutralized. completely. See, I was really hoping for the emeralds, which I guess we really don't need because we have the enhanced pumpkin farm now, and the redstone. You know, I thought that those would be too. Although the redstone output for a raid farm, I don't think is that high. It depends on how well you build a raid farm, I suppose. But plus, I never built a raid farm before, so I was really looking forward to that. But I guess we're going to have to find something else to do. So I don't know. I may go into the test world and fool around with iron farm configurations. And then get my stuff together. And then we can... I don't think we'll be able to start that with the stream. In fact, the stream might be a little shorter than my standard 2 hours. It depends. We'll see how I'm feeling about this. Oh, crossbow. Yeah, we've got to get that pillager head back to the severed head pub in town, in Castletown. So I'm going to head on over here, and I'll use Nebs's portal to get back. That way you all can see a little bit of Nebs's build as well. So far, that has been the very first and only slight misgiving I've had with the mod, really. Because I have loved this mod. Gosh, this server would seriously do well with Create. Makes the acquisition of iron so much easier. If so, yeah. I've yet to use the Create mod, Chu. If you don't mind me calling you that. For short. I haven't been really too much of a mod guy up until recently. We did the Buffoon Skies mod and limited series, and I don't know if you saw that through Chris's streams. And then we have this mod that we're running on Season 5 here. But other than that, you know, on my own server, you know, I usually just run that fairly straight vanilla. I have some resource packs, some data packs. But that's about it. But that Create mod does look fascinating. Shut Mountain has done quite a bit with mods. I don't mind at all. Great. All right. Let's get back into town and do what we can do with whatever time we have here. I mean, there's a lot going on in the server right now. The other buffoons have been very, very, very busy with their buffoon plans. It's just I have not, I myself. So I haven't been that particularly busy. Let me think. From where did I enter? I think it was this one, right? Actually, I should have gone a little bit further down and gone into the... There we go. My mouse pan has been... Yeah, doing well there. Okay. Just seemed like I was moving a little slower than usual. Create lets you cobble gens to grind score. Speaking is tough. To grind stone, the cobble into gravel. Wash the gravel with fans pointed through the water or to drive off the moisture. Okay. Giving you flint and iron nuggets, which you can auto-craft into ingots. So, Chu, you and I don't really know each other that well, so let's rectify that, shall we? So, do you stream Create Mod? If so, I'd really like to stop by one of those. You know, I probably should with how much I play. Okay. All right. No pressure. Some of the other buffoons and friends and viewers of buffoons also play Create Mod, so of which I'm sure you're aware, right? Let us do some. So, yeah, I live in the pub, which is a very Thunderhand thing to do. One of the things I can do is I did borrow the beacon from one of the towns nearby that pillager tower, this gold beacon. I think the town is called Queensland, something like that. I did borrow this beacon, so I should put this thing back because I'm done with it for the time being. Let's do a little organization here. Let's save some of these crossbows. I might make a mini game with crossbows at some point, although I don't have the idea of it sussed out yet. Do I have a category for Blackstone? Probably not. Let's do a little bit of that. Let's just do a little bit of organization here. Get this stuff worked out. Let me see. Tools. I know these are crap gold tools, but sometimes, you know, I can get rid of those super, super quick. So let's get rid of this dut. That's going to be over here. Right here. There we go. We can do this. We can do that. And let's get caught up in the chat. I literally had no idea. What's your role on the server? I, sir, am but a humble innkeeper. You can use iron trap doors to open and close access to shoot targets in a carnival-style shooting gallery. Yeah, I was thinking of something like that for the crossbows. Yeah? Yeah, I was thinking something similar. I've seen a lot of crossbow games, so it's just a matter of I would like to have it be a very redstone heavy kind of game. I just haven't thought of anything but yet. I was putting that off for later, but I don't know, maybe now that raid farms are off the list of things to do, the latest edition. So the name of the pub is the Severed Head, named such for its proximity to the public guillotine, but we affectionately call it the Head for short. But that's definitely an addition I wanted to make to the decorations outside said pub. Yes, I am the humble innkeeper, though. That is my role in the mod in the server this season. And again, the idea for a mega base just hasn't dawned in my wee little innkeeper brain yet. So, yeah, I don't really have anything set up for that. Excuse me. One of the things I could do is I have been brewing Potion of Regeneration 2 and relabeling that as Guinness for the pub, the extra stout. So one of the things I could do is I could, there has been some remarks or comments, we will say, that our selection of drink in the pub is rather narrow. I'm fine with just this. Some of us are. I know Nova and I are fine with just this, but maybe we should increase the selection. But then again, you know, I don't want to infringe too much upon the domain of our alchemist at the same time. So there is that to consider as well. So, okay, it is not a thunderstorm, so we can't do the sleeping for our friends. So I don't know. I'm thinking maybe I should log off at this point and log on to the test world and maybe start doing some iron farm design stuff. Redstone Intense. Oh, my God, that is wicked cool. Yeah, for generations, I have a maze runner kind of game for my own server. Generations is my own server and my solo server. And that's really Redstone heavy. We were considering doing something similar for Buffooncraft. And so, I don't know, maybe something like that. You know, so instead of building a base this season, maybe I'll work on a mini game for that. Like, I literally only came across y'all's content because of a friend of mine, Caps Girl. Oh, I've seen Caps Girl in Chris's stream. Cool. If it's not medicinal, go for it. Alcohol isn't medicinal. Not supposed to be anyway. Yeah. Also, Mr. Alchemist, sir, we can also, in the Venn diagram of our roles, you know, we can collaborate on some things too, right? So there is that. Like, this impulse style brew station is self-refilling. It's really cool. So if I take a few of these out, it'll auto brew and automatically brew more to replace them and stuff. And so I did try to build this in season two, but I think there were certain updates and stuff around that time in season two that that nerfed this and disabled it. This kind of design, but I got it working again here for season five. So, yay, more rain for sure. Yeah, my plan is to build all of those, but for now, I'm in a holding pattern until the world grows. Hey. Join the club. I guess I am too. Let me see. I guess we could, like I said, I could log off here. How am I doing for time? I'm almost at the halfway point of the stream anyway. I guess I could log off and log on to the test world. And we could do some iron farm design work. Maybe a ticker tape thing to tell when to make the trapdoors open, or a hopper thing. You know, Chu, you should definitely drop into our stream on Wednesdays if you can. Our Wednesday stream is when I do the stream for my own server, Generations. That's from noon to 2 p.m. on for Pacific Standard Time. Or at least check out the VODs. I don't know what your schedule's like. Or at least check out the VODs, because I alternate that Wednesday stream. One Wednesday I'll be doing just regular building in survival mode in vanilla on the world that I've been working on there. And then the alternate Wednesdays I work in creative mode on the test server. And I designed that mini game in there, and there's a lot of redstone in there and stuff. It's really cool. Like pistons. Ooh, definitely. Okay, that being said, I'm going to log off here and log into the test world. And I'll probably take a little break in between there. We're close to the halfway point of the stream anyway, in which I usually take a little bit of a break to run some ads. So we can do that too. So let's flick that off. That tells our friends, that's the on button. The on button is, off button is over here. There we go. And then we'll switch over to the test world. The test world I use not just for Generations, but I also use it for Buffooncraft too. So, all right, so let's go log off over here. There we goeth. And let's switch over to the cam scene. There we go. And let me see. So off camera, I'll switch out of this. And let me see. I think I'm still in the test world in generations right now. So I think that should load. If not, it may take a few minutes for me to do that. So let's see. Yeah, great. Okay, let's switch on back to splicing. Okay, so we're in the creative test world, and you can see this is the at least the development version of my Baby Zombie Rush game for generations, but this is not a generation stream. So, but this has all kinds of redstone traps and devices and everything all built into it. Part of it is an anvil launching hallway, which anvils come raining down upon the player. So we've got that kind of stuff. This I do on Wednesdays. But we do some generation stuff and some Buffooncraft stuff. So this is where I do all of my stuff here for that. You can see over there is the prototype for the Guardian Farm. And there's here's my initial, some of my initial iron farm work, trying to puzzle out iron farms. There's some more of it right up here. And so I think I'm going to do some of that kind of stuff here today. And let's start by erasing some of this. So there's some bounding boxes and things like that. When it comes to iron farms are pretty simple. Once you get the parameters down, I'm gonna bring this down here, and then I'm going to move this out of the way. I like to, for the sake of having these things easy to find, you can see I have my main roads, north, south, east, and west, and then I have lots for each kind of design work, design build, and stuff. So, alright, that'll be there, and let's get up over here, like this, and let's do this. And right now I'm just putting in some bounding blocks so I can delete all this stuff, actually. Yeah, that should do it. So we can get rid of this with a fill command. Let's get some cords. Hey. That's kind of weird. Okay, fill command. All right, there we go. Yes, fill command. Please do your thing. All right, so we get those cords for that block, and then we can get the cords for this block. Right there. Let's do that. And we'll do this. Pow. And that should take care of that. Oh my god, they're falling to their doom. Look at that minecart just doing that. Okay, and that gets rid of that. Yeah, so if there's any older iron farm explorations, I want to get rid of those. That way I won't cause any kind of confusion. Hopefully I can reduce that. And let me see here. Let's do the same with this one here. Right. Let's do the same with that. We want to go up with this one. Right about a little bit higher up. That's good. Yep, that'll do it. Not with the Cavs Thunder, although I'm sure it'll still work. Oh my god! Oh, that dude got lucky, he landed in the water. Alright, let's pick out a site here. Again, you know, it doesn't have to be too far away. And I'm only going to build out one module, and then we can, and decide from there. I can probably go into Affinity Designer and make a little map for it. That's one of the things I like to do. let's do this. 3G like that and turn on chunk borders and yeah, I feel like I can use these chunks here. This will be good. So we can make a lot right here for this. They all. And usually I like to keep this within within one chunk for my farms. I like to do that if I can. But this might wind up being multiple chunks. So let's make a pretty big lot for this. Let's do that. Like this. And let me see. Let's go with the polished andesite. Yeah, that should do it. Okay. And I'm going to leave chunk borders on. I know that might be annoying for some of the viewers, and sorry about that. But sometimes it helps me with the building. All right, now I'm going to build this kind of high up in the sky here. And I'm thinking of building it off of this back corner right here. And we'll start with spawn platforms and all of that good stuff. Like that. So you can see these cyan colored lines are the chunk borders vertically anyway. So there should be another one right up here. Yeah, right there. Okay, so this up here is the chunk in which I want to build in. I know that's really high up, but I want to give plenty of room underneath for building stuff, right? Let me see here. Let's get caught up in the chat. Also, Create has a schematic canon thing for to bring builds into other places. Oh, that's cool. Oh, cool. It's a maze. Yeah. That the name of that game is called Baby Zombie Rush. And again, you should stop by. This Wednesday coming up, we'll actually be building on the survival server in survival mode. The following Wednesday will be Baby Zombie Rush design. This past Wednesday, I just completed a Baby Zombie Rush design stream. So let me see here. Let's do this over here. So that's my public Discord for our community and stuff. You can get our stream schedule, all the information off of that. And let me see, that VOD for last Wednesday for the Baby Zombie Rush design stream. That'll be up there for 11 more days. But if you go to our YouTube, for some reason my YouTube command is not working, but on the Discord you can get our YouTube link. That's Thunderhand 64 underscore gaming 2, and we archive all of the VODs on our YouTube channel, and so if it's past the 14 days, it gets downloaded there automatically, and I have all the stream archives going back about 3 years, for about 3 years of stream archives. I don't know why that's... Let me check that very quickly. Fossabot, what are you doing or not doing, or what am I typing wrong? Let's just assume, because... I'm old. Let's log in with... Let's assume that I'm wrong and I'm not typing it correctly. Commands. There's Discord. Oh, okay. That's why. Yeah, see, it was me. I didn't type it in correctly. It's this. There we go. Because that's for the second channel. There's the link for the YouTube right there. All right, so let me see. Iron Farm stuff will be on the West Road here, okay? And we'll do this lot right here. Okay, so we're on the bottom of this chunk here. All right, but that's actually not incredibly important. One of the other things I want to do is I want to pull up the wiki for Iron Farms just so I don't forget the parameters and stuff, because, again... I'm almost 60 years old now, 59 this year, and short-term memory isn't what it used to be, right? So, Minecraft. Let me see. I think Iron Golem is what I want, right? So there's a couple of things to consider here, right? Villagers spawning iron golems, that's, we need those parameters. And also scaring radius or radii of certain mobs, right? Like a zombie is different than a pillager, for example. A pillager, I think, goes up to 15 blocks as a scare distance of 15 blocks, if I'm not mistaken. And I think a zombie has 12. But we can look those up too. So that's Iron Golem. So depending on what size of farm I'm building, I might switch out the mobs, right? Sometimes I want to use a pillager because I want the farm to be bigger and to have more modules. So those modules have to be farther apart, and so that means I need, if I'm going to use one mob, I need to use a mob that has a big a larger scare radius. You know, in fact, I think pillagers have a scare radius of like 24 blocks. It's big. Or use a zombie is much less, and so if you want to make a very compact farm, you use a scare mob that has a much smaller scare radius, right? And off camera right now, I'm just pulling up the wiki for these. Okay, there it is. Great. All right, now before I get too much into this, I am halfway through the stream. I'm actually over by about 8 minutes. So I'm going to take a little bit of a break right here. Usually I get something to drink here, and I don't have my drink here. For Buffooncraft, that is like, wow, really? Thunder. So let me go get that. I'm going to take a little break. I'll be back in like 3 minutes or so. So let's switch over to Be Right Back, and let's do that thing. Okay, and welcome back. Sorry, Mrs. Thunderhand needed a hand with some groceries and stuff, so took a little longer than I anticipated, but that's fine. Even though my streams are family-friendly streams, I consider Buffooncraft to be a little bit more on the mature side, so my drink for this afternoon will be the mighty, the lovely McEwen's Scotch Ale. I'm only going to have one of these, even though it only takes about 4 to 6 of these before I even feel it. That's because of me, not because of the drink. These are about 8% by volume. This is some pretty heavy-duty stuff. I love this. It's one of my favorite ales. Sláinte. Sláinte atáinte. I think that's the last one I have in my fridge, too. I'm going to need to go out and get the next batch of drink. Let me see. So where were we? We were doing iron farms, right? And I believe that the best way to start these things is to probably figure out where the villagers go first. All right, so let's take a look at this now. One of the things we have to do is consider the detection range for the villagers, their detection range for the iron golems. But let's place the villagers first. And I'm going to go for the more compact kind of design. Now, I forget, and maybe you viewers who have done this before can confirm this, whether the beds have to face, this is important too, whether they have to face this way. With the head of the bed on the outside or the head of the bed on the inside. I suppose I could just call up a picture of the standard kind of iron farm, right? Like this. Maybe not. I know I don't need that many blocks. I just need one block to place them on like that. I've done different configurations of this before. I've done the bed side by side and stuff like this. The advantage of having them all crowd into the one block standing space is it makes the farm a little bit more compact. So let me call up a view of that. Get some images here. Now, this is for the type of farm that would be built in the air. You can build these things on ground level and stuff like that, too. So. Let me restart the music, too, while I'm at it. The playlist. There we go. Okay, now we're back. And let me show you my display screen here. Is it display 2? Yeah. All right. So this is at what I am looking right now. And there's all kinds of configurations for this. And then once you get an idea of how these things work, then you can start changing things up a little bit. I don't particularly build the same kind every time, and that's probably not a good thing. Let me see. Yeah, some of them use a job block, some of them don't, right? Now, ideally, if I had planned on this being the stream, I would have worked all of this stuff out ahead of time. Yeah, some of these use the job block and some of them don't. The thing I don't like about the job block is I don't like them hopping on top of it. And right now I'm just scrolling through the images because I'm looking for that, the particular kind of bed design that I have laid out right there. And again, you know, if I use somebody's design for the majority of the farm, I'll give them credit in the description. Yeah, see, some of them use these kind of modules like this, and I've used those in the past. Like I used that in season four. Yes, I needed a lot of iron for season four. You should go to the Buffooncraft Discord. I think that is... And thank you so much. Thank you so much for that follow.
Let me see. I think it is BC Discord.
Yeah, there it is. Okay, yeah. So you can go on to the Buffooncraft Discord. Alyssa, hey, watching a stream for the first time. Hey, welcome, welcome. My name's Thunderhand64. I'm mainly a Minecraft streamer, but on Sundays, I do more of a variety stream with my son, Kachi, and he does whatever. My son, Kachi, is 12 now, and whatever he wants to do, I do. It usually winds up being Roblox, but for the most part, I'm a Minecraft streamer. Today I'm streaming from the Buffooncraft SMP, that's the SMP of which I belong, to which I belong, and right now I'm actually in my test world designing something for... How are you doing? I am doing awesome. How are you doing? And thank you so much for the first time view and the follow, I do appreciate that. Right now I'm just looking at... at iron farm mechanics in my test world and stuff. And so, like I was saying, usually I've built different kinds of villager modules. Most of the time, I haven't wound up using a job block in there at all. So, sometimes I've put just the three beds together in parallel with a standing space for each villager, and I'm looking for a picture of a farm with that kind of a configuration. And you know what, I maybe people don't use those anymore, I don't know, because I'm not seeing any. But I'm thinking for a very compact farm, that might be the way to go. Yeah, see, okay, I'm, you know, I don't necessarily want to watch the video. I just want the thumbnail. Okay, yeah, so they're using these slabs around the bed to prevent the villager from falling out with no blocks underneath. Okay. All right. They have the all-important lightning rod on there, though. That is super important. And let me see, it's probably more than three blocks high above the villager's head. Yes, it is. Okay. That turns out to be very important. I found that out last season. Where am I doing from? I assume, where am I streaming from? I'm in Southern California. So I'm on Pacific Standard Time. How about yourself? Well, where are you from, if you don't mind me asking? I'm not native to California, though. I originally come from the from New England. I'm originally from New Hampshire. That's why I talk the way I do. and that's why I have the sense of humor that is not common to California. let me see here. Yeah, so I'm not really seeing that configuration except this here. So this here is using this kind of a thing. I think they're just using slabs just to save blocks. Right where, you know, if it's early game and you're really scarce for materials. Like this. That way they can sleep, but then when they wake up, they really don't have any blocks on which to stand other than this one. And so they pop right into there. And all three of them will share this same block here. Let me see. Then it looks to me like they have some sort of block at brain level. Maybe like right here. Yeah, I can't get that single block up there for some reason. There we go. There it is, like that. I think they're doing things like this just to keep this guy in here. The two blocks that you can see that are in front there are to keep the zombie from jumping too high up on his... I guess they're using a composter in which to hold the zombie there. That's fine. I'm more of a fan of the using the track system, as you'll see, right? So, but this is good enough. But one thing I would like to do, though... is install that lightning rod. Now again, if you're underground, I don't think that this is so critical. But if you're up in the sky, absolutely, because otherwise lightning will zap your villagers and turn them into witches. Which has happened on more than one occasion last season. Okay. Now again, despite the way this may appear, I do know how to build these farms. But what I want to lay out is I want to lay out the boundaries for just one module, and then from there I can decide. Like, then I can configure it however I'd like. You know, once I get one module in place, then I can decide. Last season I built a 3-module farm. I made it an odd number just because I liked it. This season I was thinking of a 5-module farm, but we already have a farm in there. We're just upgrading the existing farm. And Supernova Relic last season built a 4-module farm that shares the same spawning platform. And it was very compact and very high output, and I'm thinking on doing something like that. If you get the spawn areas and detection areas laid out, you can converge them and arrange them in such a way that they share areas, and it makes the farm very, very compact. And I did like that design. It was super efficient. I went with 3 just because I wanted to make an odd size farm. And I was thinking of making 5 this season, but like I said, I'm upgrading the iron farm that Shut Mountain has already built. He has a 2-module farm right now. And so, you know, I'm thinking of just trying to keep that pretty much the same way it is and just tacking a few more modules on him. And maybe I'll bump them around a little bit, a few blocks this way, a few blocks that way. Just to do a little bit of tweaking. A wee bit of tweaking. I tell you, there's nothing like that McEwen Scotch Ale. That is, if you partake in such libations. That's one in, that I highly recommend. Just beware, again, it's 8% by volume. So that's, for an ale, that's pretty heavy duty. Pretty heavy duty. And for mere mortals, that may, a very few of these may have a big impact on you. Let me see. Villager egg. Villager spawn egg. So let's put three of these dudes in here. E. R. Sun. Okay, that little dude spawned because the adult was in his way and stuff. So hopefully he'll grow. If he doesn't, we'll knock him out of there and put another adult in there. But you need at least three villagers to spawn iron golems. That's the idea. All right. And so I do believe building these farms, this is the first thing you have to establish. And then from there, you can start building out. I think the very next thing to do is to establish their spawn box around them, which I think is 16 blocks in each direction. But I want to make absolutely sure. All right. And you guys also can't see the... let me turn this off. There you go. All right. So this is what I have here. This is the lightning rod to protect them from being converted into witches. If you're building in the air, if you're underground, you probably don't need this. Maybe just an extra slab right there to keep them from falling out. But if they're high enough in the air and there's no adjacent blocks or anything, they should stay right there. I really doubt that they'll push themselves off the, just walk off the edge. Crowding, though, they might nudge themselves off, though. So there is that. So you may want to put that extra slab there if you don't have this in place. So let me see here. So like I said, spawning platform for the golems is next. Now, this depends on how you're going to kill the golems. If you're going to kill the golems in the overworld and you're going to do so with lava or fire, and you're going to have them spawn and then drop, it's better to have the spawning platform under the villagers because it's less distance for them to fall out of the 16 blocks detection range. And the moment they fall out of that 16 block range, that means that the villagers can then spawn another one. As long as there's a golem in that 16 block range, they won't spawn another golem. So the idea is to remove that golem from that 16 block range as quickly as possible. Again, if you're using gravity and they're dropping down, that only makes sense to put this platform under them. Because if they're going in a downward direction, that's less blocks they have to fall to get out of that detection box, right? If you're using a portal and shooting them over to the nether, then that doesn't really matter. I like to have this as early game design as possible, so I probably won't be using portals just for this. Let me see. So let's confirm that block range. Let's do that. You guys can't see this, but I'm off camera looking at the web page right now. An iron golem is detected when it is within 16 blocks of a villager. All right, and I'm going to assume that that's at head level for the villager. I think it is. And that's in each axis, right? And so we could do something like this. Now, if you built it on the chunk border here, right, you could measure over with a chunk border. But let us... I'm thinking, do I want to use glass to mark this out, or do I want to use wool? Let's use glass. In fact, let's use the That was supposed to be T-I-N, by the way. Family-friendly stream. Is that some sort of Freudian typo? Maybe. Let me see. Maybe colored glass. Or maybe just uncolored glass. That should be fine. All right, so let's do this. Eye level block will be right there, right? So this slab would be one, so that would be two. Like that, and then 17 would be the outside, right? So we can think of it like that. Like this. Okay. That I wanted to double check this one. Yeah, I'm good. Okay. And then let me see. This is one. So it has to be inside of these glass blocks, inside of them. So these glass blocks are 17 away. So inside is the spawning area. Like this. This one is conveniently right on the chunk border. Then we can use a fill command for the rest, right? Sure, Thunder, whatever you say. He asked himself, and he replied to himself. Oh, I'm way past. That's right. That's why I have a chunk borders up. And once I get these in place, I can turn the chunk borders off. Because it's a little annoying to see for while you're building. At least for the viewers. I get used to it after a while. But sometimes I get comments from the viewers. Can you please? F3G. There we go. Okay. So, let me see. Iron Golem is detected when it is within 16 blocks of a villager. Right. So you can see the dilemma, right? An Iron Golem has to spawn and be moved outside of this area as quickly as possible. But this is just 2D. Let's go 3D with this now. So let's consider that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Let me see here. I wonder now, 16 blocks of a villager. Okay, so it's plus or minus. All right, so I am correct there. Now I lost count. Awk. Right. There we go. So that's the uppermost height. Right there. And then let me see, this will be one. Two. That will be three. That's 17 right there. Okay, that's cool. So this is the bottom most part. Right, and you can see again why you would want to have the spawn. You would want to have the spawn platform as low as possible. These guys could spawn an iron golem here, and then it would just have to be pushed off from the water and dropped. Right. And then the closer it is to this, right? So ideally, I think the spawn platform would be one block above this, and then it would drop off right away. All right. So I'm going to now I'm going to do this kind of a thing. That flying villager, summon the men. Villager, how are you doing today? The spiciest of buffoons. How goeth it? Actually, I want to come up to here, I think, so I'll just build it up from the bottom up. Okay, that's cool. Then if I, let me see, if I get the other one over here. That's a little too high. I think right there is where I want to be it. So if you're just joining us, villager, although you may have been lurking during that time, I'm not sure. But I'm just getting my iron farm basics down in my creative test world. And I'm just getting them recorded here so I can then use them to do a layout for an iron farm and then upgrade the iron farm that we already have. I just got home from work, so better than about 10 minutes ago, I suppose. I tried, but service was not good. Vermont, right? You know what I'm saying? All right, let's do a fill command here. There we go. Okay, so the idea again is this is the spawn box for these villagers here, right? That's the idea. And you know what? We actually don't have to fill in like all of that. We can just do the edge boundaries here. That should be enough. I was considering opening up the stream today by playing a little bass guitar, but this morning was a wacky morning. My hands are, like, again, I'm a pretty old dude, so I need to warm up for an hour or something to get my hands working again before I play. And I just did not have that hour today. So. And again, once I have these Iron Farm basics down, I can then just use this to configure any kind of Iron Farm that I want. On the fly. Because, again, as we've mentioned earlier, the short-term memory isn't what it used to be. I mean, it was never particularly good, but it's a heck of a lot worse now. So, hence, that's why I have these things recorded in the test world, because I'm a very, very slow builder. And so if I have this stuff recorded in the test world, then I could just refer to it and quickly whack these things out. And again, I don't need to fill this entire thing in like I started to do up there. I just need the bounding box edges. That should be fine. It should be just fine. Let's bring this corner down. Ugh, hands. What a show. What a shoji. Soldier. Let me see. Vermont, indeed. There are, they can cause a raid area. I don't think that has as much to do with being as it does out of practice being old. Oh, yeah. Well, that's a nice thought, villager. Thank you. I will accept that concession. Again, I might have been saying raid farm because that's been on my mind lately. This is Iron Farm Basics. Iron Farm Basics. This one I don't need to erase with a fill. This I think is small enough where I can just come by here and just knock these out. Although the central one I would like to keep. Yeah, I like to keep that central block right there. There we go. Just as a marker. The soothing ASMR of breaking glass. All right. Here, though, we can do a fill command. Okay, but as we did below, though, I would like to get the central block in place there. And just get these axes like this. Well, I was a little bit off. Perspective in Minecraft is very weird. At least I find it is anyway. I don't know about the rest of you, but. I can hear my projective geometry professor right now going on about projective geometry and parallel lines meet at infinity. But in Minecraft, sometimes it looks like they meet not at infinity, but like right next to each other. All right, but this doesn't need to be in here, though. We can take that out. Thusly. Let me see. These, I would like to put these axes in here. It just makes things faster to measure on the fly. Right. And I'd like to drop one down from here. Just the midpoints of each one of these planes. Great. Again, I'm marking out the spawn area, the detection area, actually, of the iron golems. This is the iron golem detection area, so the villagers can see an iron golem within these bounds. That's the idea. And I think this is the last axis to put in place. And let me check in with chat here. Let me see. Yeah, we're doing well. Okay, so the villagers, once they're scared, they will spawn an iron golem. And then the idea is to, we have one more axis to put in there, is to remove the iron golem from this box as quickly as possible. That's the idea. As long as there's an iron golem within this block, the villagers will not spawn another one. So some iron farm mechanics here for you. And I have for the longest time been meaning to lay these out in my creative test world. All right, now if I'm not mistaken, an iron golem can spawn on a minimal platform of 5x5. So let's verify that over here. Pow. All right. So let me see. So an iron golem is detected within 16 blocks of a villager, plus, and that's plus or minus 16 blocks, and I'm assuming that's from the villager's eye line from their head. All right. Villager scans for iron golems every 10 seconds. Villager has not been near a summoning villager in the last 30 seconds. Let me see. When gossiping, at least 5 are needed. When panicking, at least 3 are needed. So, if you're going to do this without a mob to scare them, I assume you need the job blocks so they can gossip. You need a village square area which they can go to gossip. And you would need 5 of them. If you're going to use the mob, which is the most common one, you only need 3. The mob appears, causes them to panic, and then leaves their site so that they can rest. It's important that the villagers are able to sleep. Valid spawn point for a golem is found. To find a valid spawn point, up to 10 attempts are made within a 17x17 box centered on the villager. All right, so this is the spawn area, not the detection area. All right, and I don't think I really need to consider that area. Maybe. If, for example, I would want this because I intend to have the iron golems drop into some lava or campfires or something. If that's the case, I'd want them to be as close to the bottom of the spawn box as possible. So they'll spawn here and then drop, and all they have to do is clear. How tall are you guys? Three blocks. So they just have to get 3 blocks below this, and then these guys can spawn another golem. So that's the idea. So the idea would be to be as close to the bottom and one of the outer walls as possible, right? So maybe the spawn area, not the detection area, this is the detection area. So we'll do the spawn area in a different color. All right, so let me see. To find a valid spawn point, and this may be too small for you guys to read on the screen. We only have 4 more minutes left of the stream anyway, so... to find a valid spawn point, up to 10 attempts are made to spawn a golem within a 17x13x17 box centered on the villager. Okay, they're all odd numbers, so that's a good sign. Villager block position plus or minus 8 blocks along the XYZ axis and 6 blocks along the Y axis. Oh, okay. All right. So, and again, I'm assuming that's their head, that's their eye line. So, 6 blocks up, 6 blocks down, and 8 blocks out in either direction. All right. All right. So that to me, let's go with a white glass for that. White stained glass. Let's go. Yi er san si wu liu, like that. And so this would be moved over here. Yi er san si wu liu, like that. And again, we want within this, so this will be bounding this. Right? And again, just to be sure, e r san si u. Yeah, we're good. E r san si u. Leo, like that. Okay, so within that, I believe, is where the iron golem spawns. It's detected here, but it spawns there. Right? So I think that that's what they mean. All right. If I'm wrong and you guys know otherwise, please, you know, backseat gaming is allowed and encouraged, so I certainly don't mind. And then from here, it's going to be out 8 in each direction. E-R-San-Z-U-Liu-Chi-Ba. like that. Okay, and then similarly down here, right? Like this. And again, you know, I'm going to put the axes in here just in case I'm measuring out. Uh-oh. You know what I think I did? Yeah, I centered it here instead of here. That's not good. Like that. And again, if I'm misinterpreting this information from the wiki, do chime in. I'm the most secure man you're ever going to meet. Okay, we just had our little ad break, which is usually at the end of the stream. We are at the end of the stream right now, as a matter of fact, but I'm just going to finish up this one part. And then pretty soon I have to leave to go bring Kachi home from school. Now, if I understand it correctly, this should be the spawn zone right here, this box that I'm outlining with the white glass. Like this. Let's get these columns up on the sides here. Again, this is mostly for measuring purposes. It depends on how the farm's going to be orientated and stuff like that. So I like to have some axes in place like this so I can count blocks over. Great. Uh-oh, that one's a little bit off. I think this one's out a little bit too far here. Oh, I'm going to the outside of the blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 on the inside. Yeah, this has to actually come out by one. So the top part's right, and the bottom needed to be moved over to make that correction. That's right. Not a problem. I don't mind going over stream time just a little bit, just to make sure we get this right. That means that column's going to have to be moved. That's not a biggie. Not in the least.
Right, we got to move this over a little bit. Remember, these are the outside borders, so it's within this box, right? Not including these glass blocks. All right, there we go. And we need to grab these two edges right here. I could do this with a fill command, but the box is so small, right? It's not worth it. At least I don't think it is. Let us then put in these axes right here on their eye line. Hey, dudes. Like this. I'm going to take away the blocks that are over their beds. And again, the lightning rod's only necessary if they're up in the sky, right? If they're in the open. Although in the past, you know, I have been struck by lightning while I've been underground. That has happened. It's a little weird. But I don't know if they nerfed that or not. And I want to get this boundary right around here along the outside. That's eye level. Like this. Okay, now the idea is, the way that this is supposed to be helpful is, these guys will spawn an iron golem inside this box somewhere, and then the iron golem needs to be removed from this outer box as quickly as possible. Right, now within this box, you need a 5x5 spawning pad. That's the idea. Now, the 5x5 spawning pad, you can put anywhere inside this box. Right, and so that helps you configure where these guys need to go, right? Especially if you're going to put combined modules, right? Because some of this stuff, as you can see, can overlap, right? And so you can fit these modules pretty close together, and they can do things like share spawning platforms and stuff, right? So. Okay, but we are at the end of the stream. That being said, let us log out. In order, though, as a streamer, I always have to think of thumbnails. where are their little faces? Which direction are they facing here? Oh, they're all facing inwards. If I get close enough to them, they'll all look up at me like this. Or maybe sometimes they will. Let's do an F5 like this. There we go. I'm thinking, let's go up a little bit. Okay, I think that's pretty self-explanatory. I think you guys could tell by a thumbnail of this that I would be working on a iron farm boundary box kind of thing in the test world. So we can do that. All right. Wow, all this time. You guys didn't tell me that I needed to switch the screen. I was on the other display all that time. Let me get off of this. There. That's what I was looking for. All that time I was playing, placing blocks, and you lurkers didn't let me know. That's okay. My responsibility, not yours. With that, let us check. Let's take a look at Twitch. And let's see if there's anybody to whom we can raid out. Okay, we're going to raid out to Kamakwa, because I haven't seen Kuma in quite some time, actually. So that being said, let's do a raid out to Kamakwa. There's our raid message. You can copy and paste that into the chat if you would like to join us. And I always encourage you to, if you can't stay for the entire stream, at least drop in, say hi. And if you feel so inclined, a follow or sub or some bits would be super, super cool. Just family-friendly viewers, just a reminder that Kumakua, his channel is for mature viewers. Sometimes there's a little bit of language, but Kumakua is a lot of fun, a lot of fun. In fact, right now, they're streaming Baldur's Gate 3. So, yeah, all right. So let's do that. Let's check them out. Let's set up the raid. There we go, and the raid is counting down. Okay, so this Buffooncraft stream we do every Friday from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m., and I think we're going to stick with that schedule from here on out. And next Buffooncraft stream, I'll have better, more decisive content for you. So our next stream will be Sunday from 4 to 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That will be our Kachi Time stream. Kachi, I think, wants to show off some of the OSTs that he's created for his game, which is the game theme music, or original stream music, right? Then after that will be on Wednesday from noon to 2 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That will be our Generation stream, and we should be in the survival world. Vanilla world, doing the terraforming outside the hotel on the beach. Okay, with that being said, I would like to thank everybody for dropping on by, and thank you for the raids, and thank you for our new viewers and followers for dropping in, and please come back next time. Enjoy the rest of your afternoon, morning, evening, wherever you happen to be. Bye for now, everyone.